Good evening, everybody. How's everyone? This is Gaming and Still Life. I am Rich. I am your host. And today I have a question that keeps coming up. It's about how do I do racing games? Now, I found that the mixed reality platform, which is my Samsung Odyssey, works great for this. I bought this wheel. I picked it up for like 150 bucks. It's the T150. I got it for my PS4, but it does work with my PC pretty well. So I built this PC, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to hook up, and I'll be up in no time on the Steam store, and I'll play one of the racing games real quick to show you. So. All right, this is how quick it is. Set this down here. Well, I want to show you a little addition that I did. I went to Walmart and I bought these little suction cups that they're like for bathrooms, and they use to hang like hang towels up and stuff. And I got these suction cups and I super glued them here so they wouldn't slide around, because I have a wooden floor, as you can tell. And it has worked for me, so let me just show you. So I put where I want to put it. I suction cup it down, so it's not going anywhere. All right. Let's see. Now this comes with a clamp. Basically, I get my steering wheel. I set it up to the edge of the desk where I'm going to be using it. And I get the clamp and I put it down here. And I start screwing it up a little bit. And I tighten it on my desk right here, just like that. Now, you don't want to tighten it too much, because it is made of plastic, so I don't want to break anything. All right, so I get and I plug my steering wheel in, and I put in the USB port. Just like that. I get the okay. Now I'm going to turn on video. I'll minimize this. I'm going to go in my Steam app, if I can find it. All right. I'm going to go with Steam. I'm going to show you just how easy. I'm going to be trying one of the games that I found that to be better as far as the resolution is concerned. It is a great game. Alright, now once I'm here, what you want to do is you want to go to Tools. And go down to Steam VR, and I right click it, and I go ahead and see if you look on properties, I am opt out right now. So I just play game. Now what this does, it loads up my Microsoft portal. Now what you want to do is sometimes is you want to make sure everything looks okay in here, and it does. I'm not using the controllers, and I go to my games and I pick iRacing. So Let me find it. If I can find it, I find it. iRacing right here. And since I have Steam VR open, it's gonna ask me, do you want to launch it in your VR helmet? I say, okay. Now, on this one, it's a separate page. It takes you to a web browser, basically. So, I'm doing my iRacing sign-in, which it goes through Steam. I'm signing in. Alright, and bam, it takes me to this page. Now, from here, all I have to do is, let's say I'm going to do a practice. I'm going to do the Mazda, we're going to do Laguna Seca, and we're going to test out the car on the track. Now, basically, now when you first do this, it's going to go through a tutorial, and it says it's detected, and you want to start full screen? I say yes. And now when you do it, you're going to want to, there is a thing on the options where you can set to recenter your display, so like you won't be like on top of the car or in the hood or something. So I set my, I believe in this game, it's to the one of the top or the bottom button right here. I'm not 100% sure, but let's try this out. Alright, and you gotta have your mouse handy because there is some clicking things that you do have to do once it's setting up. Alright, so basically right now my mouse is ready and I'm going to go see our replay options. We're gonna go to test and see how the look is really funny. I reset it because I already set it to one of my buttons. And alright, now usually I don't use this chair right here, I use a different one. But this is just for an example. I have my shifters, the process of setting everything up is really good. The detail, there's not just a sweet spot in like a certain area. Like even if I look off to the sides, the detail is really good. The graphics look really good. It feels like I'm inside the car. I can see my legs. I can see different parts of the car. Stick it in first gear. And here we go. Now this game, it doesn't hold your hand. You have to abide by the rules. There's no... I re-clicked at the center of my heads up display. There's no... what's it called? There's no automatic shifting. You have to shift. So I have it set to my paddles. The braking is very realistic. I do get a good feel of the road with this. Now when I shift, I let go of the gas and I shift with my other gear. Now, when I was playing Drive Club VR, when I had my PlayStation, I could not play. It would make me sick. Like, one time I got so sick, I was sick for an hour, that I was like, you know what, that's it, virtual reality is not for me. I got rid of my PlayStation VR, and I was done with it. Well, then this came out, and one thing I liked about it is that there was no cameras to set up, and I was thinking, well, you know, $399, you know, the Oculus is really, you know, what I want, this and that, but, like, you still had to buy another camera to be able to look behind you. With this system, you don't need none of that. It does it all. I have found out that this system works really well. I think it's the best headset that you can get for any kind of driving game. I highly recommend it, and not only because of the resolution. And I am getting excellent frame rates. If you look up there, it says 90 FPS. Those are my frames. The stock car racing is really awesome in this game. Alright, so let's Let's try to do a good lap here. The sound effects are unbelievable in this game. They really do sound like, really, like, real fun. I do have, well, one of my buttons, I messed up. Let's see if I can catch myself. Now the only thing about this is that there is a monthly subscription. This is a good one. DS World, that flying game. I gotta show you that one of these days. I just did one on Elite Dangerous. I need to do that. That is a great game. I love that game. But we are looking for Assetto Corsa right here. And now it says, because I opened the Steam VR. This is how easy it is. Because I have it open, it automatically looks for it. So I'm going to say yes. Now on this one, you do most of everything from the menu. So basically you do everything from here, and then when it's ready it will kick you out to the headset. So it's loading right now. Alright, what's the non-responding? And make me look bad. Now, once you get into this menu right here, you have to hit options. You go to display, you go to render mode, you pick open VR, early support. You go to the game, you pick anything you want, any car you want, and you hit start. Now, until you set what buttons you want for what, The way I center the hub when it's in VR is I hit L2 and R2 and it recenters my position and it works. Now when you first get on, this is very important. You don't want to push anything. You want to make sure that your control Y is hit so you can move the cursor. And you want to go to this little thing right here. Now, once if I want, I can reset it, and it'll reset perfectly to how I need it. If I'm facing this way, it resets right there. I'm facing over here, it resets right there by hitting L2 and R2 right there. All right. Now, this game, graphics are excellent. I will say that between this and iRacing, I think this one's got a little bit more stuff to it, more detail maybe. But to me, it seems a little bit damper, like a little bit darker. Oh, I forgot about those. So.
Great. You can really get a feel for the car.
best I can. I know that sometimes everything is kind of janky, and I'm not the best at cutting videos, but I do the best I can, and that's all I can do. I'm getting better at it, and I'm not good at promoting my videos. That's why I rely on community like you guys to help share, spread the word. I'm really a nobody. The other day, there's this guy named Epics, 911. I can feel it. The steering wheel, you're going off, like, you feel the bumps, you feel like right there, boom, you feel like everything, it's just experience, there's nothing like it in the world. I mean, this is absolutely fantastic. The resolution is good. I don't have to be looking through the so-called sweet spot. I could be looking that way, but I still, and everything looks sharp. The mirror and work. This uses a combination of a gear and a belt. You can definitely feel when the car starts to slide, and you feel it when the tires catch grip. So it's a great feeling. It's definitely like the best $150 I ever spent. It's definitely a must-have if you're serious about racing with a racing wheel. This track is unbelievable. I love this track. I still have not gotten really good at it. I got this before I started making videos for you guys. It's more important to be able to put out videos, and so I don't play it as much. I will. Maybe I want to go into like reviewing some of the multiplayer. It gives me play it, but there's so much stuff out there. You guys get a few ideas on what you want. I have been people asking me about this, and basically this was my little tour on how to get a set of Corsa to work. Thank you very much. This was Gaming and Still Life. I hope you got something out of this video, and please, if you liked it, just hit that like button, and if not, you know, it's not a big deal, don't worry about it. If you really want to help me out, share my videos so more people out there can see it. And thank you very much. Follow your dreams, and all you have to do is work hard at it. You have a good night. Thank you.